This is Sarajevo, the capital of Bosnia and Herzegovina. It's not difficult to see how it earned the nickname Little Jerusalem. A walk around the bustling city centre uncovers a mosque, a synagogue and a cathedral. However, as you take a closer look, you'll notice the city still bears the scars of a conflict that shook this multi-ethnic country to its core. The holes you see on the side of this building were made by gunfire during the country's bitter civil war over 20 years ago. Following the River Bosna out of Sarajevo, there are signs of another hardship the country's northeastern regions faced more recently. Many of the houses we drive past still bear the marks of the worst flooding in 120 years.
It's a beautiful day here today in Bosnia and Herzegovina, so it's difficult to imagine that the city you see all behind you, the city of Doboj, was destroyed 2 years ago when a flood hit the city. The riverbank you see on the horizon all the way over here burst its banks, and some of the city found itself 7 meters underwater.
As you can see here, the floodwaters, caused by heavy rainfall, engulfed Doboj in 2014. But thanks to a joint initiative by the United Nations Development Project and the European Union, the city has been almost completely restored, with only a few traces of the disaster remaining.
A little more than 2.5 years ago, it was impossible to stand here because the water level in this part of town was 3.5 meters high. I remember it very well because I was riding in a rescue boat just down this street with a few of my colleagues. I was trying to cross the water, but the current was so fast and strong that it was impossible to navigate.
Sinisa explains how he saw employees and patients fleeing this healthcare center as they saw the oncoming floodwater. It's now been completely renovated. Obren Petrovic is the mayor of Doboj. If you look to his left, you'll see a nursery, and facing him is the city hall. Both buildings have been restored by the project. Amir Bradaric is a farmer whose home and business were completely destroyed by the flood.
Before the flood, I grew strawberries here, but all the strawberry beds I had were destroyed by the flood. I applied for recovery support under the EU-UNDP Floods Recovery Programme, and I was selected as a beneficiary and provided with strawberry seedlings.
Our state is a failed state. We have to fight to survive, Amir concludes, a telling sign of the struggle faced and the lifeline extended to him and others in the same position.